Una, a la dos, a la bing bong bang. Una, a la dos, a la bing bong bang.
Welcome to Colts News. It's Teacher Appreciation Week here at River Heights.
Today is Thursday, May 9th, 2013.
Hi, I'm Bailey.
And I'm Cassandra. Bring something nice for your fifth period teacher to thank them for everything they do for us.
Teachers change the world, one kid at a time, and get us ready for the next step towards being an adult.
Yeah, do your part and bring them something smart. Today inside the multipurpose room, the talent show auditions will be taking place during fifth periods from 12:05 to 1:30. Next Thursday is our Club Live last meeting of the year.
Attention, all 7th graders, Club Live is also looking for 3 leaders for next year.
Go see Ms. Vanderveen in E1808 to pick up the application.
It's time to turn in all library books.
When's the deadline?
You gotta turn everything in by May 17th.
Tomorrow, May 10th, will be the last day of the school year to check out any book.
Get your library books turned in by May 17th.
Goodwill is a good thing.
There will be a Goodwill fundraiser so you can do some good for good people out there.
Our PTSA wants you to do some spring cleaning at your house.
Bring in some of your old clothes, furniture you don't need, old bikes you don't ride anymore, all those toys you don't play with anymore as well.
It will be at Roosevelt High School this Saturday, May 11th from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. right in the parking lot.
What is Goodwill?
It's like a thrift shop, but only better.
Goodwill takes all yard sale stuff, cleans it all up, and sells it for people to reuse, and all the money goes to charity. It helps out tons of people. Do your part.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Thank you, Ms. Vanderveen. You are a great teacher. I love the way you teach, and I know better science because you taught me. We'll look next year.
Thank you, Missy. You're a great teacher, and you've helped me a lot this year.
Thank you, Ms. Kidd, for all of your hard work. You've been a great teacher. You made my experience in math wonderful.
Thank you, Mr. Wilkins, for all your hard work. I like the way you teach, and thank you for teaching me about U.S. history.
Thank you, Ms. Anderson. You've been a great teacher. I love the way you teach math, and you've taught me a lot about math.
Thank you, Ms. Walker, for teaching me a lot about language arts. You're a great teacher.
Thank you, Ms. Bertram, for your hard work and teaching me a lot about language arts.
Thank you, Mr. Mack, for all your hard work and for teaching me how to put on my future in my career.
Thank you, Ms. Gold, for all of my work and for putting in that.
Thank you, Dr. Towns, for everything you have taught me. You're a great language arts teacher. You taught me a lot.
Thank you, Mr. Ron, for being a great teacher. I appreciate you for keeping me in shape. And
thank you, Ms. Martin, for being a great math teacher. I learned a lot from you last year.
Thank you, Ms. Flanagan, for teaching me a lot about math.
Thank you, Mr. Rosales. You're a great teacher, and thank you for taking me up on that.
Thank you, Ms. Quayle, for being my favorite teacher and making the period last year so fun.
Thank you, Ms. McKenna, for being my favorite teacher last year.
Hello, Colts News. I just want to thank Mr. Potts for teaching me about computers and helping me fix my own problems.
I would thank you, Ms. Rosa, for being a great teacher and keeping me up with my work. And I love you as a teacher, of course. And you're the best.
Bye. Hi, guys. I just want to thank Mr. Morris for being a great teacher.
Thank you, Ms. Bugarin, for your hard work.
Hi, Ms. Quinones. Thank you for being a great teacher for all your hard work.
Go.
Thank you, Fortuna, for being a good teacher and your hard work.
What's up, Ms. Hopkins? Thank you for being a great teacher and for all your hard work.
Bye.
Thank you, Mrs. Hughes, for being a good teacher.
Thank you, Dr. Sapp, for being a great teacher.
Thank you, Ms. Mandela, for your hard work.
Wait, what do I say?
Go.
Thank you, Ms. Fujita, for all your hard work.
Thank you, Mr. Moran, for your hard work.
Go.
Thank you, Ms. Moa, for being
Stop.
Great.
She's not loud enough.
Thank you for... Oh, my God.
Thank you, Mr. K, for being a great teacher.
Ms. Marcos.
Ms. Walking, you're the best.
Thank you, Ms. Aaron, for your hard work.
Thank you, Mrs. Tellis, for your hard work.
I don't care if your voice cracks. Go.
Miss Elvie, you're the best. Miss Elvie, you're the best.
Thank you, Mr. Matt Connell.
Thank you, Ms. Quinones, for your hard work.
Thank you, Ms. Kyle, for your hard work.
Thank you, Mr. Hartley, for all your hard work.
Thank you, Mr. Taylor, for your hard work.
And being a great teacher.
Here's a look at this day in history. May 9th.
In 1671, Irish adventurer Thomas Blood, popularly known as Captain Blood, was captured after stealing the crown jewels from the Tower of London. They were returned, and he was pardoned. On this day in 1913, the 17th Amendment was passed. It provided for popular election of U.S. senators. In 1994, the South African Parliament chose Nelson Mandela to serve as the country's first black president. And on this day in 1950, Dianetics, the modern science of mental health, was published. L. Ron Hubbard was a fiction writer who penned a new book about how unhappiness comes from unconscious memories. This philosophy involved the Church of Scientology, converting readers into believers. And that's this day in history.
Behind every great person, there's a mother.
Oh, you're so skinny. Are you sure you're eating enough?
Mom!
Joan, honey, you'll never get a boyfriend in armor. Try capri pants. Mom! So, you can invent a phone, but you can't call your own mother?
Mom!
Comb that hair!
Mom! You forgot your scarf! Mom!
You know, Vincent, sometimes I think you're just not listening to me.
What?
Okay, we're back.
Why are you sad?
Because I haven't ordered my yearbook yet.
You haven't?
Do some chores, beg your parents for the cash, get your $30 from Miss Bertram in D104.
You mean there's still time to get one?
Yep, there is. Cash or check. Just go get it if you haven't got your yearbook yet.
Any 8th grade girls interested in joining Roosevelt High School Color Guard for next year?
Then go to an info meeting at Roosevelt High School on May 13th at 7 p.m. in the Roosevelt High School band room.
If you want an information flyer, just pop into the Roosevelt High School office for one. Okay, 8th graders, it's trimester 3, but you can't mess up now.
That's right. In order to keep
to walk at with your friends, with your family watching you, you need to have at least a 1.5 GPA.
To be able to participate in promotion activities like the 8th grade dance, baseball game, and other fun stuff, you need at least a 2.0 GPA, less than 70 period absences, less than 3 ed code violations, and during third trimester, no missing Saturday schools, and no missing library books or textbooks.
And any current 8th grade girl, if you want to join the girls' tennis team at Roosevelt High School, just look at the info, posters in the hallways, or contact Mr. Potts. Summer is almost here.
It's time to go to Hurricane Harbor.
Club Live has a deal for you.
On Saturday, May 18th, you can buy tickets for $29 for Club Live members
and just $39 for non-Club Live members.
There are only 40 tickets left.
And you must sign up by May 12th, that's this coming Thursday.
Go see Mr. Vanderveen in B108 for information. Well, that'll do it for us today.
Thanks for watching Colts News.
We'll see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.